Onshape is proud to announce the release of PCB Studio Beta, a set of tools that enables collaboration between MCAD and ECAD design. Physical PCB layouts can be created early in the conceptual design cycle, and along with context-based keep-in and keep-out areas or volumes, immediately shared with the individual or team responsible for the ECAD design. In this example, the main board has been created in the context of the handset assembly, and an in-context copy of the display is added to that layout, defining a keepout. It is then synchronized with the board layout in PCB Studio and shared. PCB Studio's library is where basic and detailed model data is stored for the various components which make up a circuit board assembly. Library administrators define the location of the library folder, as well as those who have access to it. The primary function of the library is the definition of both physical and property data for those components which populate a board anytime PCB assembly data is synchronized with PCB Studio. In this manner, automatic substitutions can take place, reducing workload and improving efficiency, letting designers and engineers focus on design. Once a design has developed to the point where the physical relationships between the MCAD and ECAD designs are ready to be checked, circuit board assembly data is read by PCB Studio. Any component substitutions previously defined in the library, such as those made for the B3U switches, are made. If needed, additional component substitutions can easily be made on the fly, and Onshape's familiar insert dialog is used to both locate and select those components. Once all the desired substitutions have been made, PCB Studio creates the part studio for the board, as well as the board assembly itself. Mate connectors, group mates, as well as any of the other assembly tools can be utilized, and the completed circuit board is then inserted into the assembly. Any additional components required, such as the antenna, are added, and the assembly is checked for fit and finish. A visual inspection shows that the USB connector on the circuit board and the connector port in the enclosure are out of alignment. There is also an interference detected between the antenna and the inside surfaces of the antenna cover. Switching to the circuit board assembly, the position of the components on the board itself are quickly updated to resolve these issues. Alternatively, assembly mate and in-context relationships can easily be defined between components on the board and those features of the enclosure that the board interfaces with. Once any potential conflicts between these components is resolved, the updated circuit board assembly is synchronized with the data in PCB Studio and then shared with those responsible for the ECAD design. Onshape PCB Studio Beta, your solution for collaborative MCAD and ECAD design.
You can now create detail views using an enclosed spline or polygon. In the past, detail views had to be defined using a circle, but with these additional options, you'll have greater control over the shape of your detailed view. You can now directly reference existing geometry when creating a variable. In the variable dialog, you'll see a new option for measured. Here you can select existing geometry and assign that measurement to a variable, creating variables that are driven by the geometry. In this example, we want an evenly spaced pattern between these two faces of the part. So we can use the new measured variables, select the two faces that we want to measure, and a variable will be created that is linked to that value. If we use our variable to drive the pattern instance count and change the length between those two faces, the pattern will automatically update. We're excited to announce a new intersection curve feature. Like the name implies, intersection curve allows you to create a curve at the intersection of surfaces. Simply select intersection curve from the toolbar, then select the surface or surfaces that intersect, and a curve will be created at the intersection. The benefit of this workflow is it's faster than other workflows like using split, and the original surfaces remain intact. With this update, you can now create nested feature folders in a Part Studio in Onshape. Simply select features from within a folder, right-click, and you'll see the option to add selection to a folder. You can now manually override the value of a cell in a BOM table in an Onshape drawing. To override the value, select a cell in a row with a defined part number, and you'll see a new option to override. Simply check override and type in the new value. You can see that a cell's value is overridden by the indication in the bottom left corner of the cell and by mousing over it.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.